In this video, we will learn 5 useful Google Sheet features which everyone should know. And the first is highlighting the duplicate entries. For example, I am entering the result of my students on my Google Sheet, and when I reach here and I start to enter a student name, student's first name, and this name is already here in the above students, so the color of this cell will change. So it will indicate to me that I should double check whether this is a new student with a different second name, or I am just trying to enter a name which I have already entered. The second feature we are going to learn is finding a trend in a data quickly without making any chart. So here is the data of blood sugar level for a few days, and I want to see the trend in this data without making any chart or spending a lot of time. So you can do this within few seconds. The third feature which we will learn is protecting ranges, and I will show you how I can protect any range in my data. Even if I share the sheet with edit permissions, someone will not be able to edit that particular range. The next feature we will learn is how to freeze the header row, which is a very simple thing. And the last feature which we will learn in this video is how to create an interactive checklist, where I have a checklist with checkboxes, and once I have completed a task and I check a checkbox, then the task will be striked through. So a line will appear on that task that this has been done. So these are 5 features. So let's get started from the first one. So to highlight the duplicate entries, we have to use conditional formatting and click on format and then conditional formatting, and this pane will appear on the right hand side. I want to put this in both first name and second name column. So I select the range to apply here. I click here and I select this first column by clicking on this B, and it will show me B colon B. It means complete column, and I click OK. And now the color is changed because it is applying the default formatting rule, which is not empty. So because these cells are not empty, so rule is satisfied, so default formatting is applied. I want to change this rule, and I want to make my own custom formula, and the formula is very simple. What I want to check is that I want to see count if in the column B, and I put the first entry, and I ask the system to check whether it's greater than 1 or not. So there is a colon here which I have to remove, and then this will become blue. It means the formula is valid. And now what I'm asking the system is to check that B1 entry, when you count, the count is not greater than 1. So it means that as soon as the system will get a count 2, it will apply this formatting. And if I am happy with this color, that's fine. Otherwise, I can change this to these 3 colors, or even to custom color by clicking on here. So let us see, I want to change this to yellow, and I say done. Now similarly, I have to apply for the second column, which is C. I add another rule here, and now this range is okay, or you can change this to C colon C as we have done in the previous, but it is fine. Now the formula is again custom formula, and we this time say count if in C column C1, and if you find it's greater than 1, then this time apply red formatting. So red will indicate to me, and I can change the text color to white, and I said done. So now you see only one rule here, but actually both rules are there. And if you want to see how many formatting rules you have applied to your sheet, what you should do is you have to select the complete sheet by pressing Shift, Control and Space, and you will see both rules here, or any rules. If you accidentally have applied some default rules. So now if I start typing, let's say Robert, and I press tab to go to the next column, it will be highlighted. And this is the time for me to see whether I am typing the name of another student starting with Robert. For example, that student could be Matthew, and that's fine. Later on, I can clear the formatting of all these cells. So this is a good helping tool when you are entering data. To clear the formatting, you can simply delete the rules if you want. So Shift, Control, Space, and then you can simply delete these rules if you want, and the formatting will be gone. Now the next feature is quickly finding the trend. And this is very simple. You have to choose a cell where you want to see the trend. So let us see, I want to see the trend at the end. So I have to type a formula is equal to sparkline. And inside the parentheses, I simply give all this range and enter. And it will show me the trend in the data. Now, in order to make this clear, you can increase the height of this cell and see it more clearly. So this is the quickest way to see trend in a data. Now the next feature is how to protect a range. So this is my data and I want to protect this column. Let's say any column, total sales column. I select this column, I click on data, and I click on protected sheets and ranges. And now as you can see, whole column is selected, E colon E, and I can put any description, for example, protected by my name. And now I can set the permissions. If I click on set permissions, the default is only you can edit this range. And this is what normally we want when we want to protect something. So if I click done, then it will save this. Now, even if I share this file to someone, and with the edit permissions, that person will be able to edit all the sheet except this range. And let's share this to someone. So I type one of my other emails and I say send. So now I have shared this with my other email address. And if you want to see what permissions, as you can see, I can click on share and advanced, and this I have shared. And if I click here, I can see that I have shared with edit permissions. So now see what happens if I log in with this account and try to edit this range. Now when I logged in with my other account, I will see this message: you are currently signed in as this, because on the same browser I have signed in with both accounts. So now if I try to edit this entry and try to put something here, I will see this message: you are trying to edit a protected cell or object. Please contact the spreadsheet owner to remove the protection. So this is the message I will get. So let's click OK. So, but if I want to edit any other cell, I can edit it easily. So this is how you can protect any range. Now the next feature we want to learn is how to freeze the header row. So header row is where you put the title of your columns. This feature is useful when you are having a large spreadsheet. So as you can see, my spreadsheet has hundreds of entries. So when I scroll down, my header row is not here. So I want to freeze it here so that it can be visible all the times. So this is very easy. You just click on view, freeze, and now you can freeze any number of rows you want. So I only want one row. So now this row has been freezed. And if I scroll down, my header row is always there. And you will see this dark gray line here under this row. And if I undo, now this line is gone. You can also freeze this row by dragging this line from there to under this row. So this is another method. Now the last feature we want to learn is how to make an interactive checklist in Google Sheets. Very useful feature. It improves the quality of your spreadsheet. So this is my checklist for publishing videos on YouTube. These are certain tasks, and I want to put check boxes here. So I just click on the first cell, insert checkbox. Then I can drag this and apply this to all tasks. Now I want that whenever I check this box, this text is striken through, a line should appear on this text, and maybe the color is also changed. To do this, we will be using conditional formatting. And another fact that this checkbox has one of the two values, either true or false. If a checkbox is checked, you can see it has a logical true value. And if a checkbox is unchecked, it has a logical false value. So we will make use of this value to write our formula and conditional formatting to strike through this C column. So to do that, format, conditional formatting, and the range we want to select is this range. Press OK. Now we want to change this default formula to custom formula. And formula is very simple. We want to see when this cell, which is B2, when B2 is equal to true, you strike through C2. So this is the icon for strike through. And now I can check all this column that whether it is working or not. Before even pressing this done button, I can check all the entries. And when I'm happy, I can just click done. And now this checklist is working interactively. If I uncheck this, it will go back, and if I check this, it will change the color. You can change this color as well. If you click on this rule, here is the colors available. You can change this to gray if you want, and now when you check, the color will be gray. So this is how you can make an interactive checklist in Google Sheets.